The following episode of Tyson Johnson's Meet the Fighter is brought to you by Underground Locals.
As we wrap up our whirlwind tour of the islands, the team decided to make one more stop and drop in on Bryanna Fissori, the Pink Ranger. She was working out at the BJ Penn UFC gym in Hawaii. This place was wall-to-wall high-tech equipment with plenty to do to stay in shape and sharpen your MMA skills. We caught up with Bryanna as she began the second workout of her two-a-day training routine. The dynamic duo of coaching and training is Coach Guy and Coach Rich. They were just beginning to put the Pink Ranger to work. From the start, Bryanna was showing good hand speed and power. Her kicks were strong and targeted. I heard she was a banger, and she was definitely morphing into the Pink Ranger. We have the pleasure to be here at the UFC gym in Honolulu, Hawaii. We're talking with the Pink Ranger, Bryanna Fissori. Bryanna, how are you today?
Aloha, I'm doing well, thank you.
Thanks for bringing us to your lovely island.
Glad you could make it. It's good.
Tell us a little bit about the Pink Ranger. How did you get that nickname?
The Pink Ranger. Well, it's always great to be a superhero, so I'm really excited about that. But I am a child of the 90s, so I grew up watching the Power Rangers. Despite that information, when I first started jiu-jitsu, my coach put me in a pink gi. And he allowed me to wear the pink gi with the contingency that if you're gonna wear a pink gi, you better be good. And I was good enough to wear the pink gi. So we started calling it the Pink Ranger suit. Somebody just kind of coined that, and I'd put on the Pink Ranger suit, and it was morphin time. Now I don't need the suit, although I still have it, and it's still morphin time every time I go into fight camp.
We're here at the UFC gym in Honolulu, Hawaii, with Coach Rich and Coach Guy. These are the two coaches that are behind the Pink Ranger, Bryanna Fissori. I just want to kind of get a little background on how you guys got involved with Bryanna.
Yeah, I met her first before Rich. Rich came on a little bit after, but I was with a different group, Soma, South Oahu MMA, and we had just started up a group, and Bryanna came in from a Craigslist ad, says, "Hey, we're starting up a fight training." And she was interested, and she started up. And actually, when she first came in, she was really interested in fighting right away. She's like, "Coach, I'm ready. Put me in." And I said, "Let me see what you got." And then I was like, "Oh, you need a little bit of work still." So we put in a lot of work in the beginning, and we trained for a good year, and I started her off on jiu-jitsu tournaments, grappling, and found out that was pretty much a strong point for her, and yeah, it's been history from there.
I was introduced to Bree through Guy. Guy brought her in for some cross training. I had a couple female fighters, a couple female boxers, kickboxers that Bree could move around with, and she came in and sparred and decided to just come on. I figured that I had a couple things that I could help out, and me and Guy work really, really well together. It's really funny because sometimes when we don't see each other for a couple of days, we'll still be on the same page. Like the other day I did takedowns, like pushing takedowns with her, and turns out that he did it the day before.
Yeah.
So it's just funny. it's just one of those things that
like
works
mine.
Out. We've been working together for maybe four years now, and it just, I don't know, we see things in Bree that she needs.
Bryanna, so tell us a little bit about how you got started in MMA.
Sure. Well, my MMA roots go back just a little bit farther than Hawaii, but not much. I lived around the corner from the Pit, John Hackelman's The Pit, in Rio Grande, California. And it was close enough for me to run in the mornings and do the cardio classes. And it turns out I liked it. They did a little more than just cardio, so I got kind of a taste for MMA. So I knew the basics. And then I moved to Kansas City for a while. Kind of life took me a couple different places. Ended up in Hawaii. So I answered a Craigslist ad in Hawaii for female sparring partners. And I ended up at South Oahu MMA with a total of me, two coaches, which are Coach Guy and another coach, and one other sparring partner. That was it. And started small, the team grew, I grew with the team, and ended up in the cage.
What is it that you guys saw in Bryanna that made you think, hey, this woman's got what it takes to actually be a professional fighter?
So on a lot of fighters that I've dealt with, men and women, a lot of times men, you know, they can kind of slack off and it's hard to get them motivated. Where with women's MMA, there was hardly any, but actually Bree was an exception because when Bree came in, she was a hard worker and through this training, she's like, oh, I'm in the gym already. I'm doing my cardio this morning. Yeah, I'm coming in for Muay Thai at night. I'm coming in for Jiu-Jitsu tomorrow. And a lot of times I'd have to say, slow down. But you know, one of the things that I saw in her was her motivation. And she was strong, she was a hard worker, and her professionalism for following through with the details of the fight. She follows through with most everything, so it's easy.
So how's your workout?
All right, feeling good.
Feeling good?
As always, as always. That's what happens when you have the best coaches in the universe.
We're just gonna work on a little fine detail.
When I started on the pads with Muay Thai, you started with just boxing. Just boxing, footwork, it was kind of a blend of, I want to say, like traditional boxing along with elusive Muay Thai.
Well, I think Brianna's going to give me some of that Pink Ranger power right now. She's going to be beating down on me.
We'll be right back on Tyson Johnson's Meet the Fighter.
What do you think? What's your opinion on women's MMA?
You know, I absolutely support anything that's going to empower a female to defend herself, and taking that to the next level is MMA when you perfect those skills. I had a blast in my amateur career. One of the difficult things about being a fighter here in Hawaii is that it's hard to find opponents because you train with everyone that is in your weight class already. One thing that happened with me that doesn't always happen here in Hawaii is that I was able in my amateur career to go and travel a little bit. So not only did I fight different venues here in Hawaii, we fought outside, like right next to the water, which was awesome, at Aloha Tower. That was a cool fight. But at the big arena, Blaisdell Arena here in Hawaii, which is a big place, to the smaller Waipahu Philcom. So used to all different vibes here in Hawaii, and then I fought in New Jersey, and I fought in Vegas, and I fought in California as an amateur. So I got used to the traveling, used to the weight cut, and how to do it going different places. So my coaches did a great job of prepping me through the amateur career.
They sound like two great coaches, and they've done, as we mentioned earlier, a lot for you. If you could say one thing to each one of them, what would it be?
Without crying? I'm gonna try without crying. Coach Rich, one of the most caring people that I know, and if I could say to Coach Rich one thing, it would just be that whatever you're going to do, just do it. God's always got him, and he's always got me. Coach Rich has always had my back, and I will always have his, so whatever he wants to do, I'll always support him the way he supported me. Coach Guy, has just been through the ringer with me. And he's just amazing. I mean, just, there's no reason that he should still be standing next to me when I get in that cage. We've just been through so much. And he's an angel. He really is. Through everything. For as much crap as I give you, Coach Guy, as much as we've been through, as much as we don't like each other sometimes, I love you so much.
I know she does work out twice a day at least. Is that your making? Is that by your design?
Yeah. That was like the start maybe years ago, but then she just took the ball and ran with it. She knows how to run through the program, so she knows what hoop she has to jump through to get there. One thing that the biggest thing that I found in her was just like any other great fighter, she listens. She has the ability to listen, learn, absorb, and repeat, and she does it over and over and over. She's the type of person, if I tell her to fix this footwork and do it repetitively, if I say 5 hours, I know she'll do it for 5 hours. I could walk away, go get lunch, go to work, train a couple of people, come back, and she'll still be doing it.
There's so many different arts out there, and they're all sports in some sort of sense. They're arts and sports, whether you consider boxing an art or a sport, or you consider, you know, jiu-jitsu is more of an art, but there's sports jiu-jitsu. Sports are great all the time, and MMA is a sport. It's for entertainment, but it's so much more. There's so much more than just the beat downs that you would think of, and that women can be a part of it now and really shine in that arena as well as other athletics is very empowering and very inspiring, and I hope that it continues to grow.
Well, gentlemen, I really appreciate your time. I'd like to thank you once again. We all look forward to the things that you're going to be doing with Pink Ranger. We know that she's on a good hard track. She's got some good fights coming up, and we have you two guys to thank for it.
Thank you.
Coach Rich.
Thank you.
Coach
Guy. Thanks for coming out.
Thank you.
And now to your fans, your friends, family, what would you say to them?
Believe in yourself and know that we're all superheroes. Just because I'm the Pink Ranger and I morph every fight camp doesn't mean that we don't all have a superhero within us. Got the Iron Man. I mean, it's in you, and don't be afraid to move mountains. It only takes faith and mustard seed to move mountains.
Well, there you have it, ladies and gentlemen, a mustard seed. We're here with the Pink Ranger, Bryanna Fissori, at the UFC gym in Honolulu, Hawaii. Thanks for joining us here on Tyson Johnson's Meet the Fighter.
29-28, all for the winner by unanimous decision, Bryanna, the Pink Ranger, Fissori.
You see the emotion on the face?
Meet the Fighter.
Meet the Fighter.
And you're watching Meet the Fighter.
You're watching Meet the Fighter.